Right in the van to the chair.
What's that?
Hmm? Okay, let's go. We're just wandering around for a minute. We're not going to bother anything.
Mommy? Is that me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. Mommy?
Don't, just if he starts getting off,
please. Okay, I'm going to leave anyway. We're just going to walk for a minute. Yeah.
Papa.
Yeah. We're not going to stay very long because we don't want to disturb the wedding. You want to see him? Go see him. Hey, Louie, boys. We're going to go walk around a minute.
There's a play area right behind you.
We got plenty. We're parked right down the street, you know, on the same street. Let y'all out. We just went down there and turned around. Yeah, yeah. Okay, well, you get them for me. But let them get them.
I'm going to let Mary drive.
Mary. Okay. Okay. Well, let's go, Ross. Come on.
Bye, Mary.
Bye.
Bye-bye, Mary. Bye-bye, Mary. Bye-bye, Mary. Bye, Mary.
Say bye, Mommy. Say bye, Aunt Susan.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
There's wedding outside. We'd be better outside.
Let me just say hi.
Hi.
No.
No.
That's,
you don't want to say hi.
That's Emily.
Okay. I'll see you later, Ross. Bye. You have a good time with Papa.
Yeah. Yeah, hi.
Yeah. You going to play a while?
We're going to go walk around some.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And play with Papa.
Yeah, play with Papa. See y'all later. Go see if we can get out this door, Ross. Yeah. We can get out. Go ahead. There's old Ross. There. Look, Ross, come right over here. It has a steering wheel. Yeah. You can make it. Sit down. Sit down on it. There you go. You can do it. Sit down. There you go. You can make it. There you go. That's the way to do it. There you go. There he goes.
Took him around to the play base there because Is that your grandson?
Uh-huh.
Oh, good.
Yeah, I was sure that he would be talking out. I didn't think that would be good.
Hey, the dance floor is open.
Let everybody else start playing.
about it. Nice wedding, wasn't it? Y'all want to dance?
Yeah.
Won't you dance with Ross there? This is Ross. Won't you and Ross dance together? Dance, Ross.
We got Ross on the dance floor.
Gonna dance? No, don't dance. Go dance.
Thank you.
Okay, we've got a request. Let's do a slow song, man.
Come here, Ross. They call his name, but Ross is on the dance floor.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Well, ran around.
He was looking for y'all. She was in there looking for y'all. She didn't
okay.
Yeah.
in the middle of it.
Thank you.
disaster winter.
Thank you.
I did cut the piece.
I said, I hope I get a big piece of it.
Oh. You get to cut your own.
Yeah, we're good.
I mean,
somebody...
good, doesn't it, Dwayne?
Whatever that is, I wish it would get out of my eye.
I do too. Which is the window there?
Yeah.
just... Yeah, let's try it then.
Where is it?
Just go down, go out to the main road and go down. Yeah. Hey, Georgia Power is coming. Yeah.
They might have this on tomorrow.
They may.
Doesn't that make you sick?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah. Left, yeah.
See that on that house right there?
Yeah. It's okay. Yeah. Look at that car. Back up, if you don't mind. Pull out of the road a little bit. Where's probably one coming? What kind of car I reckon it? What would you like it
at? Honda Accord.
Wow. Yeah, that's one of the worst ones, ain't it?
Guarantee you.
That'd be about bad anywhere. Well, I live in Village Mill 1. Y'all got it worse than we did here.
Really?
We're right up here.
Oh, yeah, Village Mill 1.
Yeah. We're right up here, and we got absolutely nothing.
We barely
got
anything.
That's amazing.
I mean, it's, we have a few little, you know, shingles off the roof, but...
Window out, and that's it. Yeah.
We have angels and God with us, believe me. We had two of our grandbabies with us, so I was...
Well, there's no injuries anywhere here.
No.
It's amazing.
It's
amazing.
Yeah,
well, it's something. I've been working all day chainsawing, and I thought I'd come look. I'll tell you.
Sad.
Yeah. It's sad.
Yeah, it really is.
But thank God no one was hurt.
Yeah.
Which is amazing.
How about Jeannie's
Selby's?
They got
a bunch of trees in their house.
Yeah, we're right over there. I hadn't seen them. Well, see y'all.
Sad.
Yep. Yeah. Awful, awful. Yeah. He said, who is that? A old Ford, man. I don't believe it. We're gonna go right here if we can.
We'll show them this traffic how hard it is to get through.
Happening in 1 or 2 minutes. We'll go down to the next street and turn right on to the Jeannie's Selby Jim's house. Get them on the way back. Yeah, stop right here. All right, now let's get with it, boys.
Hey, that was smart. How's everything going?
Pretty good. My back is so sore. I've been chainsawing all day. This is my son-in-law, Craig.
Hi, how you doing?
Jim Selby.
I just got into town today. So
did you?
I just started work.
Yeah, boy, you came in a good time. Yeah. Where are you now?
Well,
he was scheduled
to go to Florida.
Yeah.
You know, for the first Easter break.
Yeah.
But he came on.
Y'all got hit pretty good too. There's some bad ones back down there.
How was it with your house?
Well, I thought it was bad, but we got mostly big trees. We got one limb through the roof, but mostly, anyway, we had big old 100-foot southern pine.
Uh-huh.
Broke in two on the pool.
Really? Did it damage your pool?
Yeah. Yeah, I ain't even, you know, I don't know. I just have a happy-go-lucky. Just glad everybody's safe and all that, you know. We'll be able to...
And let me tell you, it could have been not so.
I know.
Had that tornado touched down, anybody who wasn't in a basement would have been killed.
That's true. That's true. It's up a jet stream that did it, yeah.
And the storm cloud itself was moving at 50 miles an hour, I heard on the...
Yeah, I was up and watching it on Channel 2. They were tracking it. They said it's going to hit Dunwoody at 12:32, 37.
Yeah.
And I said, well, it won't hit here, you know. And they always say that. And at 12:30, 29 or 30, I heard something going, oh, like a big jet engine. And I said, I better holler at Carol.
And so you were upstairs?
No, she was. I was down the den, and I woke her up. And then the time I got her awake and down there, it was here. So we hit it for the basement, yeah.
Well, we were watching it on Channel 5 on Fox.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they listed it, and the newspaper said, this is serious.
That. Yeah. Well, we're going to go. We'll see y'all
okay,
later.
Okay, take care.
Take care.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Good, take
good.
Care.
Good luck.
Yeah. Some of them got spared pretty good right here. Some were lucky.
They were about
to count. Mm-hmm.
All the way down through there.
Yep.
Cleared it out.
Yep. You can see the path right under. Yeah. All those tops. Way down there. Boy, boy. This is one to remember, ain't it? Mm-hmm. Did the El Nemo do this? They blame it on it?
I'm sure they will.
Yeah. Everything was so pretty this time of year, too. Yeah. Go. I won't do their car when they got one that got hit up there. I want to just do that. Let's see, go up a little bit more. Up there, yeah. Get your car?
Huh?
Did you get your car there?
Yeah.
Well, could have been worse. I don't know which is the best way to go out. I'm kind of thinking. And let's go this way, right. And I think, go back, let's see, go to the right. A little bit more if you can. Got it, didn't it? Hey, Manny. What's your Bill Martin here? How you doing? What's the best way out, do you think?
What? Best way out?
Yeah.
Go up this way.
Yeah. We want to go up toward Cumming.
Where?
Cumming, 400.
Oh.
This okay. Yeah.
Go up here and make a right.
Mm-hmm.
And then you make, just keep on going and you run into Peachtree Industrial.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
You make a left. Well,
I know after that. Yeah, I know how to do that.
You make
from
a left
yeah.
and go all
okay.
the way.
That'd probably be the best way.
Yeah.
I'm Bill Martin. I don't know if you remember that.
Yeah, I remember the name.
This is my son-in-law, Greg. We live.
Hi.
Yeah, we played once on the tennis team together there.
Yeah.
Carol Martin is my wife. And
Meredith.
Right. I was just videoing everything. Selby's, they got hit a little bit too.
Yeah.
It works back down that way. Yeah.
Oh, it's pretty bad.
It is. Yeah.
I mean, you can see just the direct path right down that road over there.
It's only 1/4 mile wide, you know.
Yeah.
And maybe, I don't know, 10, 20 miles long.
Yeah. Well, we got to go. See you later. Take care.
Go up there.
I got you.
Make a right. That'll put you on Womack.
Yeah.
And you make another right, and you run into Tilly Mill.
Mm-hmm.
And then you go all the way.
Okay. I got you. That'd be the best way this time of year. A little pine down there. The pulpwood there. They got.
You get over here.
Yeah, out of the path, kind of. Fred? Okay, I got it running on. I'm just gonna record it so we can look back and see what all we can do. We're really confused on what, you know, the insurance covers and so forth. And I'll just let her take the lead.
Well, it was up in their yard, and it hit another one, and then it hit our magnolia tree, and the rest up here. And it made a hole in this road. They came in that road. You want to go outside and see the...
Yeah.
Yeah, I was trying to get me out of the car, and it just came out of the car.
We had the house looking the best it's looked in a long time.
You see all along here?
We're lucky, I know, but...
Yeah.
Now it'd be worse.
We've cleaned out back here so we can get out. We couldn't even get out. I took my chainsaw.
On the inside, what happened at the roof, I hope that doesn't do anything, turn that light on. And it came through, you made a hole up there in the roof and it came through the attic there. And it came down here.
Mm-hmm.
And see this floor, hardwood floor, you begin to bubble up and see all that?
Okay, check.
Because it was wet. You know, it was, you know, I tried to get it up since I could. But I don't know if you can see it. You see it better if you're in there. You see, can you feel that? You can feel it. And it wasn't like that before, so. Actually, this refrigerator started leaking too. And it's bumping a little bit up in here. I noticed right here. This one right here. You know, refrigerator, electricity went off.
Uh-huh. We took three or four coolers worth up to her mother's house, up to Gainesville, but it already...
Y'all pay for food spoilage? That's what something else has got.
Freezer. I would imagine, so I've got to check the policy, what we normally do is report in.
Well, we feel very fortunate to have a company like Amica.
Yeah,
they've been excellent in the past history. We've had them for 25 years, I guess. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know that up in that playroom, going mm-hmm. into that, you know how it was buckling? Is that because of the roof up there?
Yeah.
You know, I told you?
Yeah, probably. Well, he'll have to look inside the roof when they start, you know, that. Just whatever he wants to see. I hadn't even looked at it since then. But I caught about 10 gallons of water through the roof, you know, with some 5-gallon buckets I had.
I put some down here, but, you know, it was just kept raining, so it kept coming in.
And I'll be glad to make you a copy of this tape if you like it. But I don't guess you'll need it. You're right now. You got your own system.
Yeah.
This will be good for us.
You want to go up in the attic and see
okay.
up there for the whole, you want to show them? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay.
This is this is my sofa got soaked. And this thing here got dirty,
Billy,
isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
The pillows, you know, mm-hmm. all those pillows on there.
Glass everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Screens, couple screens are broke.
All this put together was ugly, you know. It was all wet. Yeah, we hadn't done a whole lot back in here. Just okay. They came out and put, you know,
tarp up. Home restoration did that, yeah. Had wings.
Yeah, I've been all over.
Where do you think the roughest area you've been to?
Looks like it's pretty bad around here.
Mm-hmm. They say, Happy Hollow and Kingsland, the Village Mill 2 over here. Have you been over there? You know where it's at? This subdivision has two areas, 1 and 2. And 2 is just, oh man, we're lucky from what they got. Just go straight on back. No, this way here is easier. This way here. This is easier. They go back into... You can come on in now if you get in. Oh, be careful because it's not floored here. Oh, where the buckets are over there would be where the roof, it was sticking up about to where I thought it was sulfite when I first saw it, but it was a poplar tree limb sticking through the roof there. If you want to go on over there, up over where the buckets are is where the hole is. Huh? Yeah, just be careful. Yeah, that's what I was worried about. The other night didn't have any light or anything. Trying to catch the water, just a flashlight.
Almost runs out of film at these times.
Yeah, I'm surprised you don't have a digital camera. I want to show you my digital camera. You might want to consider it. It's a Sony, and it records on a 3.5 floppy disk, and all you have to do is just put more disk in. It'll take up to, the battery, a lithium battery will recharge up to 500 photos.
Well, I get whatever the company will pay for, and that's usually it.
I see, okay.
One of those deals.
Okay, I got you. Do me a favor while you're right there.
Sure.
Point this camera just right up there at it. Good hole. It's already set. It's on running right now. It's just pointing. Other way. Turn around the other way. Yeah, but I just want to get one in the hole. That's, I'll go. You want me to go ahead and get out first and you can get
it? Yeah, might as well. Take quarters.
I'm making sure my foot's on a joist because you can go through this little flimsy plywood here. I'll come up and turn that light off later. Don't worry about it. It's so hard to reach there. There'll be incentive for me to rewire that light. I don't know, I hadn't really, I guess you paid a lot.
It's just painted out in the corner.
Yeah, I'll just say it was a little bit warped, I don't know. But here it was all down in the driveway and I witched it back up. And I got about one chance in 100 of it living, but I sure hope it does. And I lost, I had just put out three Bradford pears and two cherries, Maraschino cherries, and two of them are completely gone and two are badly damaged, as you see. I don't know where they cover those or not. Huh, they don't? Okay. Well, it didn't hit the roof anyway.
Right.
Yeah. And we can go around this way if you want to.
Now there's graffiti.
Yeah.
That's about Louis Cowlett,
spaghetti. Yeah. Well, we're going to go for a paint job all over since we just got mostly brick here, if we can. You think that's unreasonable?
Well, I would try a pressure wash and see what it looked like.
I just had did that. I just had pressure washed, but pretty much the whole house.
Uh-huh.
I have a pressure washer, and I'm concerned if it pressure washed again, you know. Well, let me just put it to you this way. The house is going to be repainted, and if Mika wants to do it, I'd be happy for him too. If they don't, then I'll have to, but it's going to have to, because it needs to be. Some of the gutters off. You know what's amazing to me, these tornadoes? You see this rock like this about right here? Somewhere or another, there's one that it lifted up and is way down there next to the street, a rock that big. I just don't understand that.
Something else beside it would be fine.
Yeah. And it could just go on through anywhere. I don't think you're going to be able to get through that way.
Let's go back to the house.
Yeah. And I don't know about the damage up there to that screen and stuff. I don't know yet. But she told you it's two trees from our neighbor here, and we had a magnolia tree that probably saved us a lot. That magnolia tree probably really helped us. One tree did a big cavity into their bedroom up there and opened it up. So they're a lot worse shape than we are as far as the house. So we can go ahead and go now and back around. Okay. Have to go all the way around the other side.
Redwood table down there.
Yeah. We've been working on cleaning up the front. One of the photos will show the whole yard, because I realize that.
All this back off.
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah. My van got some licks on it there too, as far as that goes. It was parked right there. And I want to ask you a question.
Sure.
Our neighbor behind us here, this big pine tree is on his property. See that other big pine tree that's still standing is on his property. And there's a tremendous oak that had been hit by lightning was on his property here. That fell, and the tip of it is here with all the mistletoe. See all this mistletoe? And here's my point. He called yesterday or the day before and said, I've been feeling sorry all day, because when you asked me to help take those trees down, you know, he wouldn't do it.
Uh-huh.
And I said, I'll pay for half of it. And on his property, he didn't do it. Now he's he's saying the other way.
Mm-hmm.
But I read in a paper that I could actually sue him, because that one tree had been hit by lightning,
mm-hmm.
and it was full of mistletoe, and most likely was about dead, dying. But you'll see it. There, you can see it right there in the part of it. It's a tremendous tree.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I wanted to make you aware of all that if you had some recourse about him. I don't know. I mean, he's a nice guy. I appreciate him calling and all like that, but I sure wish he'd have took my wishes and took it down, took them down.
Which
and
one was it, that one right here?
Yeah, there's two big pines, and there's the other one. The other one was a little bigger than that one.
Right.
And the other one that went down went on the pool, and the oak went down, and luckily it came down this way, you see. We'll see it when we get on up there. But I sure hate it to come down that way, because I got a lot of damage on the pool deck.
Can you just take last weekend? No,
I just finished. This is a recycled plastic fence. Mm-hmm. We were so proud of it. I finished it last Saturday. But you might pass this along to people. This recycled plastic is the way to go.
Uh-huh.
You don't have to wash it. I mean, you don't have to paint or anything. Just pressure wash it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The gas man came out, and with his sniffer, we determined that there's a broke line in that light there. And we went and turned it off the valve in the basement, so it's all, he sniffed it all out for us.
Gutters down a little bit.
Yep, gutters down. Yeah, that was the only pole I put up. That I put a bag of concrete under each pole.
Well,
this is all one that got took down. They were. I put them up strong.
Another tree right here.
There's two trees. You can see them right there, buddy. Yeah.
That's
That's one of them old Georgia pines there. Pretty, ain't it?
That's pretty, honey.
It's amazing. Yeah, we'll get around to that. We're not there yet. Best to go under right here, I found. I don't think that's going to fall, but you got a little bit better
now.
I don't think that's the place to go under. I turned the pool pumps and all that stuff off. I'll just have to, we'll have to get a pool man out here. I figure waiting if he comes out, they'll know what to do about it and everything. Look to while you're right here, look at this big tree. Right down here. So you think we weren't lucky right there? Look at that. It's a monster.
Yeah.
This is one that was hit by lightning.
Just hit,
it trimmed our beech tree for us good here.
That's somebody else's tree there.
Yeah. Yeah. And it took the top of our beech tree off. See it right down there? Mm-hmm. I mean, this was a great big one.
It was.
Yeah. Yeah.
We have four of these. We had four of these. One, two, and there's two more there, and then...
Yeah, they're
squished. That's another plastic bench.
Was.
Well, was.
Yeah.
Plastic bench.
See this glider right here? That's out of that recycled wood, too. We're plastic. Out of Coke and Pepsi bottles?
Right.
Yeah.
We'll get
to that. I'm just going to call out our rail here, and our deck is damaged a good bit. One of the seats is laying off down there.
It looks like it might have a hole in it.
Yeah, and I don't know. I haven't been underneath to look, see if it's damaged underneath any. Don't know about that yet. I've been a little leery about getting out too far on it here. Even where you're standing right now, it could be structurally damaged on there. I hadn't even had a chance to look. But here's my main concern about the pool. You'll notice right over yonder is a lick, and then there's here licks. I think we're going to have to go this way. There's a crack. I'm even afraid to look at that one. See there? Yeah. But I do know there's a pretty large crack there. Crack in here. Let me get out of your way so you can get a picture of it. And I'm concerned about that. I'd have to start going down. Because this is a lot of fill area in here. Yeah. The umbrella is shot. Look how it just trimmed that magnolia tree just like you took a chainsaw and trimmed the limbs off. Isn't it amazing? But over there is where the main path came. You can see this looks like splinters all back through there. And it's awful. It just went from there towards Village Mill. We're about a quarter of a mile off the main path of it. Thank goodness.
And I had some, you know, a couple of wrought iron chairs over there, and I just had painted.
Yeah, we were getting ready. Well, we have our niece getting married this next weekend, and we're having everybody here Friday.
Right.
And we still
Where's
will.
The key word, eh?
Yeah, well, I don't know. We still will. I don't know. Like I say, I don't know what's under there.
I thought we're gonna look.
Yeah.
And that, yeah, I guess you see the wood, the dirt is sort of getting up there, sort of slaying on
But they put a tarp over that hole. So the, if you look and see where the soil vent pipe is there, right down below that is where the hole was we looked at up there.
in face, he says, you get your blankety blank blank rear end out of here. And he was just kidding. But you know something? He got the message. And I wasn't trying, this wasn't a revenge thing. So it's just like, it's kind of neat though. You know, Greg makes about $40,000 a year. You know something? Looks good, but he's broke. See, so there's hope for people like us, for people like me. You don't have to wear a suit, you can. You don't have to look good like Jimmy, but you can, because Jimmy can do that too. You don't have to necessarily be that way. I didn't go to Harvard. I didn't major in business. I got a history degree and I taught driver's ed. Driver's education, ain't that neat? What's that qualified to do? Teach driver's ed. I mean, what else can you do? But I wanted to do better. And that's what this deal is about today. It's neat to be able to help people in your family to do good. The things that we've been able to do and it's done for us are unbelievable. And what you can do for your family is unbelievable too. It's not even, people talk about, where's this going to be in 2 or 3 years? Heck if I know. But I'm going to tell you something. I can't sleep at night right now. And to think what's going to happen in, yeah, too many naps. You know, but I ain't gonna cut back on them things. But this is a good, a super opportunity for a lot of us that thought we never had a lot of opportunity left. And it doesn't matter your age, your color, your education, that kind of thing. It's kind of open for everybody. And that's what's so neat about it. I want to say thanks to you for coming. It's a great turnout. We're gonna empty out here, if you can, your pockets, as we don't. Open up your hearts. Thanks a lot, and wish you well. Thank you.
Well, welcome back. Let me take this opportunity to thank you for spending a few minutes to view this video. Hopefully you will now understand why Karen and I are so excited about Excel. The thing that's important to us is not only is that Excel will give us an opportunity to provide those things for our family, but at 36 years old, I don't know many people who can look back and say, I'm debt-free. With the exception of our house, by April of this year, Excel is going to give us that opportunity. Well, my recommendation is that you get back with the person who sent you this video and let them show you how you too can get started with Excel and really enjoy the rewards that Excel has to offer. Thanks once again, and I hope to see you soon.